This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to talk about matrix row operations. You've probably been doing row operations for a while without realizing it. Here's what I'm talking about. I've got a system of equations here. 4x plus 6y equals 14, and negative 1x plus 3y equals negative 5. I'm going to take the information in the system of equations and make a matrix. I'm going to call it matrix A, and the first row of matrix A will be the coefficients that I have in equation A plus the constant. So I'll have 4, 6, and 14. And the second row will be the same kind of information from the second equation. So that's negative 1, 3, and negative 5. Now, when you deal with a system of equations, you know that you could swap the order that you write the equations in, and it wouldn't matter. We could have started out with negative 1x plus 3y equals negative 5, and then had the second equation be 4x plus 6y equals 14. We can also swap the rows in a matrix. To show that I'm going to do that, I'm going to use this notation. R sub 1 for row 1, and then an arrow pointing both to the left and the right, and R sub 2 for row 2. And this means that row 1 and row 2 are going to swap positions. So using that terminology, that notation, I'm going to have a new matrix. The new matrix A is going to be negative 1, 3, negative 5. That's the old second row, now it's the new first row. And then 4, 6, and 14. Okay, so that's just swapping two rows in a matrix. Let's go back to the system of equations. You know that if you wanted to, you could take an equation and multiply it by a constant. So for instance, we could take the second equation and multiply everything in it by negative 4. Let's make it positive 4. Multiply everything in it by 4. I can do the same thing with this matrix. I could take the second row and multiply everything in it by 4, and then make that the new second row. I'm going to show that by writing 4, and then R sub 2, meaning 4 times row 2, and then an arrow, and once again, R sub 2, meaning 4 times row sub 2, 4 times row 2, becomes the new row 2. So that means matrix A is going to become, let's do row 2 first, 4 times each of the elements in row 2. So 4 times negative 1 is negative 4, 4 times 3 is 12, and 4 times negative 5 is negative 20. Row 1 has not changed, so that's still going to be 4, 6, and 14. Okay? Now, it doesn't matter if I multiply by a positive number or a negative number. So looking at the system of equations again, I could multiply that second equation by negative 2. I'm going to do the same thing with the matrix. I'm going to have negative 2 times row 2, and that's going to become the new row 2. So matrix A is now going to become, I want negative 2 times each of the elements in row 2. Negative 2 times negative 1 is 2. Negative 2 times 3 is 6. Negative 6. And negative 2 times negative 5 is positive 10. Row 1 has not changed, so that's still going to be 4, 6, and 14. And again, going back to the system of equations, you know that if you wanted to, you could multiply a row by some number and then add it to another row. We can do that with the matrix also. So let's say we want to multiply the second row by negative 2, which is what we just did, and then add it to row 1 and make that become the new row 1. So we're going to have negative 2 times R sub 2 for row 2 plus R sub 1 for row 1, and then an arrow telling us that that's going to become the new row 1. Right? Let's make our new matrix A. So I want to multiply negative 2 times row 2 and then add that to row 1. We'll do this column by column. For the first column, negative 2 times negative 1 would be positive 2. Positive 2 plus 4 is 6. That's going to be the first element in row 1. I'll go on to this 3, second column. Negative 2 times 3 is negative 6. Negative 6 plus 6 is 0. So that's the second element in the first column, in the first row. And then I want negative 2 times negative 5, which is positive 10. I'm going to add that to 14, and that's 24. So that's the new row 1. Row 2 is going to stay the same as it was. That's negative 1, 3, and negative 5. Okay, so now I've got my new matrix A. Okay, so just to review those three operations, we can swap rows. We'll use a double-headed arrow to show we're doing that. So I can R sub 1, that double-headed arrow, and R sub 2 to show we're swapping rows 1 and row 2. We can multiply a row by a constant. So I can multiply row 2 by 2, 2 R sub 2, and show that that's going to become the new row 2. Or we can multiply a row and add it to another row to change that second row. So I could have something like 2 row 2, 2 times row 2, plus row 1 becomes the new row 1. Okay? And those are your basic row operations. Take care. I'll see you next time.